Hello, traders. Gary Wagner here. It is Tuesday, 6th day of July, 2021, and this is the daily report for gold and silver. Although we had a elongated weekend with 3 days in celebration of Independence Day, we did see gold shoot up tremendously over the last couple of days. There is a caveat, and that is it failed to close above 1800 an ounce, even though on an intraday basis, it did trade to 1815. We'll talk about that along with our forecast during the price board and chart section, which begins now. Traders, after a long extended 3-day holiday weekend in observance of Independence Day, we did see gold take off, actually trading to a high of $1,815 before selling off. It is under $1,800 now at $1,795.70. It had a $13 rise in the New York session today. Interestingly enough, today's gain in gold came concurrently with fractional dollar strength, up a little over a tenth of a percent, 11 points at 92.52. Gold has certainly been attempting to stage a rally. When we take a look at our daily candlestick chart, we can see that since the 30th of last month, we have had pretty consistent up days with, for the most part, higher highs as well as higher lows. Two technical indicators that are quite noteworthy today are, first, the close in gold came above the 100-day moving average. That is drawn in cyan. We can see that it clearly closed above that. In terms of a negative, we can see that it traded to an extreme high today, right around $1,815, but closed well below that. This is Australia here. We can see that although it is trading lower on the session, that's the red candle, it is trading above the close in New York. The other noteworthy technical study involves our two moving averages, the 50-day and the 200-day moving average. Over this last week, we talked about the fact that they were coming closer and closer together. We can easily see that here. It appeared as though it could go either way. In other words, if we were going to see a continuation of a downtrend in the market, we would have gotten a death cross. However, this recent uptick in pricing has created a golden cross between the 50-day crossing above the 200-day moving average. Traders, we are neutral, and I effectively need to see a close above 1800 before I have a solid conviction to enter the market from the long side. Silver did have a strong showing in New York today, currently at 26.19 and a half cents. It is up 2 cents over the close in New York. We're looking at a daily silver chart, and although it closed above a key area that we've been looking at, which is 26.11, that is this line right here, you can see that at least in today's activity, it did close right at that price point. This, of course, is Australia. So the question is whether or not silver will find support at this key and critical area. If in fact it does, we will put that as a major support area with resistance at $27.12. And traders, copper has been attempting to stage a rally, although that rally has pretty much fizzled out. As you can see, we've got pretty much sideways trading range when we look at both the candlestick as well as our Henk and Ashi chart. It is below the 100-day moving average right now, and we need to see whether or not it can begin to close up and also move towards the 50-day moving average. And traders, we are looking at a daily chart of copper, currently trading below the 100-day moving average, as well as a simple trend line that we have simply fixed from this low here and this low here. And as you can see, prices are absolutely below that. So we could see sideways trading action to lower pricing. For me to be bullish on copper, once again, I need to see it close above the 100-day moving average. And traders, if you recall from our announcement on Friday, I am currently putting together a comprehensive video on COVID-19, its effects, and most importantly, where I believe it will take the economy in the future and what the Fed is doing and if that is the proper action. That special report will be released and available to you, our subscribers, in just a few days. This has been Gary Wagner wishing you, as always, good trading. We will talk to you tomorrow for the next Daily Update Review. Bye-bye.